Today I'm going to show you quite a useful piece of functionality in Audacity to remove vocals. So what I've got here is a piece of free music which I've downloaded from YouTube Studio. There's lots of sites that you can download free music from, but what I've tried to do is I've tried to harmonize really badly, even bad by my standards. And so I'm going to play you some music with me doing a really bad job at harmonizing to it. And I'm going to show you two ways to get rid of the vocals. So let me play you the music. La 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 la. I think we can all agree I'm not going to win any prizes for singing. So what I'm going to show you is two ways to get rid of it, and I'll show you that the ways they might be, one might be more useful than the other. So first, I'm going to assume you know how to use Audacity, but literally you just select left button click and then you just select the piece of music where the vocals are that you want to get rid of. Effect in the menu, scroll right down. There's two options. I'm going to show you them both. First, vocal reduction and isolation. So this one, it gives you a bit more control on, you might want to just reduce the vocals rather than remove them. It gives you quite a lot of configuration, so you can change it. Generally, I find it quite good. So I'm just going to show you for demo purposes, the default settings. You might want to change them. Okay, so if you can see here, the line is smoothed out, and I'll show you. I don't think that's a perfect job. I think I'd probably have to tweak it a little bit. I think if you didn't know there were vocals, you might not be able to spot them. But because I know there was vocals there, I still think I can hear something. So with the settings, you could still change those. So that's option one, and you might want to change configuration settings. I'm going to do edit undo. So I'm going to bring back my beautiful vocals again. La la la. Just great. Okay, so left click, select the music again, effect, and then vocal remover. I'm going to accept the default settings. I'll play it back now. The second option in this occasion works better. In the first example, I think I could still hear a tiny little bit of my voice. I don't know if you could, but certainly the second piece of functionality worked better on this example. But I wanted to show you both because there might be scenarios where one works better than the other. Anyway, best of luck.